Now all of you see numericals related to combination of resistances. In parallel combination, in series combination, in parallel combination already you know that resultant resistance is the sum of the all individual resistance, and reciprocal of resultant resistance is equal to the sum of the reciprocals of all individual resistances. Now let us solve one numerical related to resistance. You see, question number one is, if you connect three resistors having values 2 ohm, 3 ohm and 5 ohm in parallel, then will the value of the total resistance be less than 2 ohm or greater than 5 ohm or lies between 2 ohm and 5 ohm? Explain it. Now, solution you see. Here, three resistances are connected in parallel combination. Parallel combination means, suppose that these three resistances are there. Right now, R1, R2 and R3. Here, value of R1 is 2 ohm, R2, 3 ohm and R3 is 5 ohm. And all of you know, in parallel combination, resultant resistance, in which way we will get resultant resistance, their formula, all of you know it, we derived it. In previous video, all of you watched the derivation of the combination of resistances in parallel combination and series combination. Now, in parallel combination, resultant resistance formula, 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. Now, value of R1 is 2 plus 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 5. Now, LCM, 30 will be LCM. I know the 30 is there. Now, then LCM is 30, then here 15, here 10, and here 6 is there. Now, what will come? 21 plus 10, 31 upon 30. Therefore, but one time shall see calculation, it is right or wrong. 2, 3, 5, their LCM is 30. I hope that 2, 3, 6, 5, 30. Now, 15 will come, 3, 10, 30, 10 will come, 5, 6, 36 will come. Now, 6 and 10, 16 and 16 plus 15, 31 will be there. Now, therefore, resultant resistance value R is equal to 30 upon 31. When you write the, when you send this denominator part numerator, you know, unless you change it or by cross multiplication, anyway you do, you will, what you will get? R is equal to 30 upon 31. And you see 30 upon 31. What will come? Approximately 1 will come. Approximately 1. Approximately 1. Means the value will be 1 approx. Now, according to question, if you can connect three resistors having value 2 ohm, 3 ohm and 5 ohm in parallel, then will the value of the total resistance be less than 2 ohm or greater than 5 ohm or lies between 2 ohm and 5 ohm? You see this value is 1. 1 is less than 2. 1 is less than 2. Neither lies between 2 ohm or 5 ohm or nor greater than 5. Means resultant resistance value, resistance value is less than 2. sorry, less than 2, not less than 2 ohm. Means the value is less than 2 ohm, that is approximately 1. Right now? Ask sometimes question will come. Suppose this part is not there. Suppose that this part is not there. Less than and greater than question is not there. Less than, greater than question is not there. Right now? Simple in this way. That if you are connect, sorry, you connect three resistors having values 2 ohm, 3 ohm and 5 ohm in parallel, then find the value of resultant resistance. Then same process will be there. Same process means what? First you make a circuit diagram, beta, when you solve numericals related to resistance, then beta, if you need diagram, then all of you make diagram, because in diagram all of you get marks. Right now, and this diagram help you to solve your problem, solve your numerical. Now see, in this question, find the resultant resistance, then same process will be there. Same process will be there, only this part will be not there. This part not there. Now, approx 1 ohm or beta in division method, you divide it, 0.9 something will come. Right now, 0.9 something will come. Now, resultant resistance value is 30 upon 31. Yeah, one thing keep in your mind. Here, 30 upon 31, I hope that you are the student of class 10th. Easily you can derive it, easily you can divide it. But you have any problem to divide it, beta, don't fight in board exam. In practice, you fight, you divide it, you try to divide it. One times, two times. But in board exam, if problem is there, any confusion is there, you write up to here. This answer is also write that 30 upon 31 ohm. You will get full marks. Right now, I think that all of you understood it. Now, next question is there. Can I raise? Next question is there. Next question is there. 6 1 ohm resistances. See how many? 6 1 ohm resistances are connected to form a regular hexagon. Connected to form a regular hexagon as shown in the figure. Just I make the figure, wait. Six 1 ohm resistances are connected to form a regular hexagon as shown in the figure. This hexagon figure is in this way. Beta, you see. One, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Seven is there. In this way, I hope that. Right now, again. No, this one is not there. Yeah. This point is A, that point is B. Right now? And suppose this one R1, this is R2, R3 here. R1 dash, R2 dash, R3 dash. Now, question is, 6 1 ohm resistances are connected to form a regular hexagon as shown in the figure. Regular hexagon. Calculate the resistance offered by the combination if the current enters at point A, means from this point I current is enters. I current enters at point A and leaves from point B, and from here it passed. Question is there. Calculate the resistance, means calculate the resultant resistance, total resistance of this combination. When you observe it, then you see that R1, R2 and R3, these three resistances are connected by end to end. Same way, resistance R1 dash, R2 dash and R3, these three are connected end to end. Means first what you do? First we find resultant resistance of this combination. These three are in series combination. Right now? And downside, these three are also in series combination. Then what we do? First you find the resultant resistance of series combination of above part, and after that resultant resistance of the below part. Suppose that R1, R2 and R3, suppose that R1 and R1, R2 and R3, these three resistances of these three resistances are there, and suppose their resultant resistance be capital R. Similarly, resultant resistance of R1 dash, R2 dash and R3 dash be R dash, capital R dash. You assume it. Let resultant resistance of R1, R2 and R3 be capital R, and resultant resistance of R1 dash, R2 dash and R3 dash be R dash. Then first what you do? First you find the resultant resistance of above series combination, and after that the below series. Then what you write? Resultant, first you assume it R dash and R is there. Now, and you see that 6 1 ohm, the value of each resistances are 1 ohm, 1 ohm, 1 ohm, this is also 1 ohm, 1 ohm and 1 ohm. Now, resultant resistance of R1, R2 and R3 can arrive. These are in series combination, and series combination already you know it, the resultant resistance is equal to the sum of the individual resistances. Means, can I write R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Then R1 value is 1 plus 1 plus 1. It is equal to 3 ohm. Similarly, resultant resistance of the combination of R1 dash, R2 dash and R3 dash. What you write? We write means resistance in combination of R1 dash, R2 dash and R3 dash. What will be there? R dash is equal to R1 dash plus R2 dash plus R3 dash. Then 1 plus 1 plus 1 is equal to 3 ohm. But now you see what happened. These three resistance, when you get resultant resistance, these three resistance change in single resistance, and similarly the below part also change in single. Then you know that what happened. New diagram will be, you see new diagram, what is the new diagram? But you see in this way, this will be in this way, this part will be there. Now see, now this 3 ohm is there, R right now, and this R dash is 3 ohm. But you see here R1, R2, R3 are in series, and R1 dash, R2, R3 are also in series. Now when you find the resultant of above part and resultant of below part, again what happened? Now R and R dash both are changed in the form of parallel combination. Parallel combination means this point is A and this point is B. Now again resultant resistance, and for this resultant resistance you see both are in parallel combination. Then in parallel combination, all of you know resultant resistance value is what? Reciprocal 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R plus 1 upon R dash. Suppose that resultant resistance of parallel combination, then what to write? Now what to write? Now resultant resistance between A and B. Now resistance between A and B. Suppose that this is Rp is there, R lower suffix P, then 1 upon R lower suffix P, lower suffix P means parallel. Then what do we write? 1 upon R plus 1 upon R dash, or 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 3, that is 2 upon 3. Therefore, Rp is equal to 3 upon 2. 3 upon 2 means what? 1.5 ohm. This is the solution of given question. And but you see, I saw this question is combination of series and parallel both. In series combination, you see 6 ohm, 3 ohm and 3 ohm are there. And when you these 3 ohm resistance, you connect it in parallel, what happened? 1.5. The value of resistance increase or decrease. It means what? When you have two or more than two resistances are there, and if you want to decrease the value of resistance, then what you do? You make the combination of parallel. Means you join all resistances in parallel combination. And if you want to increase the value of resistance, then what you do? You connect all resistances in series combination. Right now, I hope that all of you understood it. Now, next question, all of you see. Next question is, what is the highest, next, the lowest total resistance that can be secured by combination of four coils of resistance 4 ohm, 8 ohm, 12 ohm and 24 ohm? Means 4 ohm, 8 ohm, 12 ohm and 24 ohm. 4 ohm, 8 ohm, 12 ohm, 24 ohm. In which way you connect that you will get the highest resistance, and in which way you join, in which way you make a combination, that lowest will be there. But all of you know, in series combination directly we add it, that's why highest will be there. In parallel combination reciprocal is there, and all of you know, if in any value is there, I suppose higher value, when you write in the term of reciprocal, then what happened? Obviously it will be lower. Take example, 24 ohm is there. When you write 24, 1 upon 24, their value is small. The smallest value will you get. Means according to question, first part solution, you see, solution of first part, for highest, we make series combination of all these resistance. Means we combine all these resistance in series combination. Means for highest, we join all resistance, we connect all resistances in series combination. Connect all resistances in series combination. And here all of you see, four resistances are there. Four resistances means what? R1 is equal to 4 ohm, R2 is equal to 8 ohm, R3 is equal to 12 ohm, and R4 is equal to 24 ohm. Now, suppose that resultant resistance be capital R, and in series combination, now what do we write for series combination? For series combination,
for series combination R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4. Means what we do? 4 plus 8 plus 12 plus 24. 4 plus 8 plus 12 plus 24. 4 plus 8, 12. 12, 12, 24. 24 plus 24, 48. Now, highest resistance is 48 ohm. And the second part, for lowest. For lowest, which combination will be there? Parallel combination. Then what do I write? For lowest, we connect, we combine, we join all resistance, we connect all resistances in parallel combination. Parallel combination. And when parallel combination, then for parallel combination resultant resistance, what will be 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 plus 1 upon R4. Therefore, resultant resistance 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 plus 1 upon R4. That is 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 8 plus 1 upon 12 plus 1 upon 24. I hope that their LCM is 24. 4, 6 is 24, that's why 6. 8, 3 is 24, it will be 3. 12, 2 is 24, that's why 2. 24, 1 is 24, that's why 1. Now, 6, 3, 9. 6 plus 3, 9, 9, 2. 11, 11 and 1, 12. Means 12 upon 24 are 12 1 of 1, 12 to the 24, that is 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2. Therefore, capital R is equal to 2 upon 1 is equal to 2. Means lowest resistance is 2. But you see, for highest series combination, for lowest parallel combination will be there. In this way, we will get the value of highest resistance and lowest. Means highest value, if two or more than two resistances are there, and for least value, lowest value, two or more than two resistances are there, then parallel. Means highest series and lowest parallel. Now, next question is how can three resistors of resistances 2 ohm, 3 ohm and 6 ohm be connected to give total resistance of 4 ohm and 1 ohm. Now here you see that problem is there, my twister is there, that three resistances are given there. How many three resistances are given there? Now it, in which way you connect, that resultant will be 4 ohm and next time resultant will be 1 ohm. Now, such type of, and you know that, a very important question is there. It is very important question. And I hope that if you have, or maybe at this time not there, but after December month or maybe October month, second PT, when in market, salt and salt papers will be there. Salt and salt paper and question banks were there, are there. Then you see that, in every your question paper, uses such type of question will be there, that three resistances are given there, four resistances are given there, and now question there that in which way we make the combination, in which way you make the combination of these resistances, that resultant this will be there, that will be there. Now here, and that question in 3 marks, in 2 marks, I think that 3 marks will be there, less than 3 will be not there. Time taken is there, but those students understand it little bit in mind, you calculate in which way you connect, in which way you combine, that this will be there, that one, this will be there, that one. Here calculation will be there. If your calculation is strong, if you know quick calculation, then easily you can solve it. Now see, in which way? One time you see the question. that how can three resistors of resistances 2 ohm, 3 ohm and 6 ohm be connected to give total resistance of 4 ohm and 1 ohm. Beta, you see, here such type of question, don't think that only parallel will be there, only series will be there. Maybe parallel and series both will be there, maybe only series is there, maybe only parallel is there. But first you read this question, you think about it, that in which way you make combination. Beta, 1 ohm means list is there. For list it is better, I think that it will be the parallel. But here 4 ohm is there, it is not 2 ohm, means it is greater than 2 ohm, 3 ohm, but less than 6 ohm. Here problem is there, which type of combination we will make it. Now, all of you see, suppose that rough work is there, suppose that 3 ohm and 6 ohm resistances are in series combination, then what will be there? But without wasting your time, here you see, if you take 3 ohm resistance and 6 ohm resistance in parallel combination, means 3 ohm resistance and 6 ohm resistance, means this 3 ohm resistance and this 6 ohm resistance, if both are in parallel combination, then resultant will be there, 1 upon R is equal to, this is R1 R2 maybe, 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 6, their LCM is 6. Then 3 1 ja, 3 3 2 ja, 6, 6 1 ja, 6, what will come? 3 upon 6 is equal to 1 upon 2, and 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon 2, therefore R is equal to 2. Right now, and beside it, suppose that here, next, this 2 ohm resistance is there, means A point, B point, this is C point. Now see, these two resistances are in parallel combination and the resultant is 2 ohm. Then what happened? Now when you get the resultant resistance, then this 3 ohm and 6 ohm resistance will change in 2 ohm. And when it will change in 2 ohm, then what happened? You see, this A2, B is 2 ohm, and now resultant between B and C is 2 ohm, then B to C, this one is 2 ohm. Now you see, A to B and B to C both are in series combination, and when both are series combination, then 2 ohm plus 2 ohm, what will be there? 4 ohm. That's your answer is there. Now in question, when you solve this problem, in which you write that we make the following arrangement of given resistance. We make the following arrangement of given resistance. In which way? You see, first part we solve. Part A, here we write, we make following arrangement to get resultant resistance of 4 ohm. And what to do? You make this diagram. And here you write, suppose A to B, this is R1, that is R2, and it is R3. Then first what you do? First we find the total resistance between B to C. First we find total resistance between B to C. Then what you write? resultant resistance between B and C. We write here resultant resistance between B and C. Then what would I parallel there? Then 1 upon RBC, lower subject BC means between B and C, is equal to what to write? 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3, that is 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 6 is equal to 3 upon 6. Therefore, RBC is equal to 6 upon 3 is equal to 2 ohm. Again, what to write? Again, suppose that to explain it, again we make this diagram. Means A to B 2 ohm, that is R1, and B to C, that is, means this is R1, R1, and that is RBC. Now, in last you write, again, resultant resistance between A and C, and between A and C means both are in series. Don't write here, these are parallel, these are in series. These are parallel and these are in series. Don't write. In diagram, you know that, the examiner will understand that. In why you write in this way, only you mention the resultant resistance between B and C. It is duty of examiner that to check it that given resistance are in parallel combination or series combination. Now what you write? Resultant resistance between A and C. A and C means, now this combination you see, A to B and B to C, these are in series. Then what to write? RAC. And RAC means what? R1 plus RBC is equal to 2 plus 2. That is 4 ohm. This arrangement will be there. Right now? Now after that, second part you see question is there. That will be 1 ohm. Beta, for 1 ohm, what you do? We make arrangement of all resistances in parallel combination. In parallel combination means what? 2, 3 and 6 all are in parallel combination. Again, what you write first? B part, you see. Here we write. We make following arrangement to get the resultant resistance of 1 ohm. And what you do? We make the diagram. Beta, diagram. If you unable to make diagram, then I think that 50% question you are unable to solve it. And those students able to make the diagram and those students understand the diagram, easily that student solve the problem. Right now, without diagram, possibilities there, but mistake will be there. Now, you see, which type of combination will be there? Parallel combination, you see that here, in this way. Now A point, this is B point, this one R1, R2 and R3. R1 is 2 ohm, R2 is 3 ohm and R3 is 6 ohm. And here you write B part is there, na? Then what in B part? We write, we make the following arrangement. To get resultant resistance of 1 ohm. Right now? Now this arrangement you show it, and after that what you write? Total resistance between A and B. Now our resultant resistance, all of you write total resistance, total anything, total or resultant, both are same, is there for this question. Total resistance resistance between A and B. What to write? 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. That is 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 6. LCM is 6. Now 2, 3 ja 6, 3, 2 ja 6, 6, 1 ja 6. Now see 3, 2, 5 plus 1, 6 upon 6, that is 1. Means therefore R is equal to 1 ohm.
It are here I solved, no? That's why I think that it is very easy, but it is not easy. Yeah, when you make practice, easily you can solve it. Now, homework, you take homework. Homework is there, all of you derived, sorry, derived not, all of you solve 5 numericals related to series combination, 5 numericals related to parallel combination, and 5 numericals based on such type of problem, that in which way you make the arrangement of given resistances, that total, that will be there, this will be there right now. And beta, don't worry that sir will check or not check in my video right now. Already it's set, my word is set, that what I told you, when school is there, then I will check it. Because you ask, when school is there, if any problem, then you ask, sir, this question I am unable to solve, I didn't understand it. Then I ask him that time, that beta, you solve or not, you try it or not try. Right now, where you make practice, you show me. And those notes you are making there, that will be in fair copy, not rough copy. And in comment box, please, please, all of you give your attendance. Your attendance is very poor. Now strength is 140, 160 is there. My strength is there, only 50, 51 comment is there. In future, your attendance problem is there, then you will bear it. School will not bear it. Okay? Thank you. Now, next question is, what is the highest, next, the lowest total resistance that can be secured by combination of 4 coils of resistance 4 ohm, 8 ohm, 12 ohm and 24 ohm? Means 4 ohm, 8 ohm, 12 ohm and 24 ohm. 4 ohm, 8 ohm, 12 ohm, 24 ohm. In which way you connect, that you will get the highest resistance, and in which way you join, in which way you make a combination, that lowest will be there. But all of you know, in series combination, directly we add it, that's why highest will be there. In parallel combination, reciprocal is there. And all of you know, if in any value is there, I suppose higher value, when you write in the term of reciprocal, then what happened? Obviously, it will be lower. Take example, 24 ohm is there. When you write 24, 1 upon 24, their value is small. Smallest value will you get. Means, according to question, first part, solution you see, solution of first part, for highest, we make series combination. We make series combination of all these resistance, means we combine all these resistance in series combination. Means for highest, we join all resistance. Connect is better word. We connect all resistances in series combination. Connect all resistances in series combination. And here all of you see, 4 resistances are there. 4 resistances means what? R1 is equal to here,
R1 is equal to 4 ohm, R2 is equal to 8 ohm, R3 is equal to 12 ohm, and R4 is equal to 24 ohm. Now, suppose that resultant resistance be capital R, and in series combination. Now, what we write for series combination? For series combination, R is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4. Means, what we do? 4 plus 8 plus 12 plus 24. 4 plus 8 plus 12 plus 24. 4 plus 8, 12. 12, 12, 24. 24 plus 24, 48. Now, highest resistance is 48 ohm. And second part, for lowest. For lowest, which combination will be there? Parallel combination. Then what do you write? For lowest, we join all resistance. We connect all resistances in parallel combination. Parallel combination. And when parallel combination, then for parallel combination, resultant resistance, what will be 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 plus 1 upon R4. Therefore, resultant resistance 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 plus 1 upon R4. That is 1 upon 4 plus 1 upon 8 plus 1 upon 12 plus 1 upon 24. I hope that the LCM is 24. 4, 6 is 24, that's why 6. 8, 3 is 24, it will be 3. 12, 2 is 24, that's why 2. 24, 1 is 24, that's why 1. Now, 6, 3, 9. 6 plus 3, 9, 9, 2. 11, 11 and 1, 12. Means 12 upon 24 are 12 1 of 1, 12 to the 24, that is 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2. Therefore, capital R is equal to 2 upon 1 is equal to 2. Means lowest resistance is 2. But you see, for highest series combination, for lowest parallel combination will be there. In this way, we will get the value of highest resistance and lowest. Means highest value, if two or more than two resistances are there, and for least value, lowest value, two or more than two resistances are there, then parallel. Means highest series and lowest parallel. Now, next question is how can three resistors of resistances 2 ohm, 3 ohm and 6 ohm be connected to give total resistance of 4 ohm and 1 ohm. Now here you see that problem is there, mind twister is there, that three resistances are given there. How many three resistances are given there? Now in which way you connect that resultant will be 4 ohm and next time resultant will be 1 ohm. Now, such type of, I knew that, it is very important question is there. It is very important question. And I hope that if you have, or maybe at this time not there, but after December month or maybe October month, second PT, when in market, salt and salt papers will be there. Salt and salt paper and question banks were there, are there. Then you see that, in every your question paper, you will see such type of question will be there, that three resistances are given there, four resistances are given there, and now question there, that in which way we make the combination, in which way you make the combination of these resistances, that resultant this will be there, that will be there. Now here, and that question in 3 marks, in 2 marks, I think that 3 marks will be there, less than 3 will be not there. Time taken is there, but those student understand it little bit in mind, you calculate in which way you connect, in which way you combine, that this will be there, that one, this will be there, that one, here calculation will be there. If your calculation is strong, if you know quick calculation, then easily you can solve it. Now see in which way. One time you see the question that how can 3 resistors of resistances 2 ohm, 3 ohm and 6 ohm be connected to give total resistance of 4 ohm and 1 ohm. Beta, you see here such type of question, don't think that only parallel will be there, only series will be there. Maybe parallel and series both will be there, maybe only series is there, maybe only parallel is there. But first you read this question, you think about it, that in which way you make combination. But 1 ohm means list is there. For list it is better, I think that it will be the parallel. But here 4 ohm is there, it is not 2 ohm, means it is greater than 2 ohm, 3 ohm, but less than 6 ohm. Here problem is there, which type of combination we will make it. Now all of you see, suppose that rough work is there, suppose that 3 ohm and 6 ohm resistances are in series combination, then what will be there? But without wasting your time, here you see, if you take 3 ohm resistance and 6 ohm resistance in parallel combination, means 3 ohm resistance and 6 ohm resistance, means this 3 ohm resistance and this 6 ohm resistance, if both are in parallel combination, then resultant will be there, 1 upon R is equal to, this is R1 R2 maybe, 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 6, their LCM is 6. Then 3 1 ja, 3 3 2 ja, 6, 6 1 ja, 6, what will come? 3 upon 6 is equal to 1 upon 2, and 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon 2, therefore R is equal to 2. Right now, and beside it, suppose that here, next, this 2 ohm resistance is there, means A point, B point, this is C point. Now see, these 2 resistances are in parallel combination and the resultant is 2 ohm. Then what happened? Now when you get the resultant resistance, then this 3 ohm and 6 ohm resistance will change in 2 ohm. And when it will change in 2 ohm, then what happened? You see, this A2, B is 2 ohm. And now, resultant between B and C is 2 ohm. Then B to C, this one is 2 ohm. Now, you see A to B and B to C, both are in series combination. And when both are series combination, then 2 ohm plus 2 ohm, what will be there? 4 ohm. That's your answer is there. Now, in question, when you solve this problem, in which you write that we make the following arrangement of given resistance. We make the following arrangement of given resistance. In which way? You see, first part, first we solve. First part we solve. Part A. Here we write, we make following arrangement to get resultant resistance of 4 ohm. Resultant resistance of 4 ohm. And what you do? You make this diagram. You make this diagram. And here you write, suppose A to B, this is R1, that is R2, and it is R3. Then first what you do? First we find the total resistance between B to C. First we find total resistance between B to C. Then what you write? Resultant resistance between B and C. We write here, resultant resistance between B and C. Then what would I parallel is there? Then 1 upon RBC, lower subject BC means between B and C, is equal to what would I? 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3, that is 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 6 is equal to 3 upon 6. Therefore, RBC is equal to 6 upon 3 is equal to 2 ohm. Again, what you write? Again, suppose that to explain it, again we make this diagram. Means A to B 2 ohm, that is R1, and B to C, that is, means this is R1. R1 and that is RBC. Now, in last you write, again resultant resistance between A and C, and between A and C means both are in series. Don't write here these are parallel, these are in series, these are parallel and these are in series. Don't write diagram. In diagram you know that examiner will understand that. In why you write in this way, only you mention the resultant resistance between B and C. It is duty of examiner that to check it, that given resistance are in parallel combination or series combination. Now what you write? Resultant resistance between A and C. A and C means, now this combination you see, A to B and B to C, these are in series. Then what you write? RAC. And RAC means what? R1 plus RBC is equal to 2 plus 2, that is 4 ohm. This arrangement will be there. Right now? Now after that, second part you see question is there, that will be 1 ohm. Beta, for 1 ohm, what you do? We make arrangement of all resistances in parallel combination. In parallel combination means what? 2, 3 and 6 all are in parallel combination. Again, what you write first B part, you see. Here we write, we make following arrangement to get the resultant resistance of 1 ohm. To get the resultant resistance of 1 ohm, and what you do? We make the diagram. Beta, diagram, if you unable to make diagram, then I think that 50% question you are unable to solve it. And those students able to make the diagram, and those students understand the diagram easily, that student solve the problem. Right now, without diagram, possibilities there are, but mistake will be there. Now you see, which type of combination will be there? Parallel combination. Parallel combination, you see that here in this way. Now A point, this is B point, this one R1, R2 and R3. R1 is 2 ohm, R2 is 3 ohm and R3 is 6 ohm. And here you write B part is there, na? Then what in B part? We write we make the following arrangement. We make the following arrangement to get resultant resistance of 1 ohm. Right now, this arrangement you show it, and after that what you write? Total resistance between A and B. Now our resultant resistance, total resistance, our resultant resistance, all of you write total resistance, total anything, total or resultant, both are same is there for this question. Total resistance between A and B, what we write? 1 upon R is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3. That is 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3 plus 1 upon 6. LCM is 6. Now 2, 3 ja 6, 3, 2 ja 6, 6, 1 ja 6. Now see 3, 2, 5 plus 1, 6 upon 6, that is 1. Means therefore R is equal to 1 ohm. It are here I solved, that's why I think that it is very easy, but it is not easy. Yeah, when you make practice, easily you can solve it. Now, homework, you take homework. Homework is there, all of you all of you solve 5 numericals related to series combination, 5 numericals related to parallel combination, and 5 numericals based on such type of problem, that in which way you make the arrangement of given resistances, that total that will be there, this will be there right now. And beta, don't worry that sir will check or not check in my video right now. Already it's set, my word is set, that what I told you when school is there, then I will check it. Because you ask, when school there, if any problem, then you ask, sir, this question I am unable to solve, I didn't understand it. Then I ask that time, that beta, you solve or not, you try it or not try. Right now, where you make practice, you show me. And those notes you are making there, that will be in fair copy, not rough copy. And in comment box, please, all of you give your attendance. Your attendance is very poor. Now strength is 140, 160 is there, my strength is there, only 50, 51 comment is there. In future your attendance problem is there, then you will bear it, school will not bear it. Okay, thank you.